to you. The Lord turn his face toward you and give you peace. The Lord bless you and keep you, make his face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord turn his face toward you and give you peace. Amen. 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 Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Send warring angels. Send them with swords that have been dipped in the blood. Let them begin driving out the works of the devil. Let them begin to cut, cut, cut. Let me hear the church say, cut, 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 cut. Destroy that devil, that lying devil, that whoremongering devil, that perverse devil. We bind you, Satan. The blood of Jesus is against you. The blood, the blood, the blood. We bind every infirmity of every individual that's listening to this tape today. Come on, church, and take the blood. Come on, warring church. The blood, the blood, the blood, the blood. Come on in the prison. We apply the blood, the blood, the blood. The blood, the blood, the blood, the blood. The blood, the blood, the blood. The blood, the blood, the blood. Oh, yeah, na 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 na. Hallelujah. Oh, yeah, na 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 na. Hallelujah. 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 Oh, thank God for the blood. Oh, yeah, 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 yeah. Ooh, victorious blood. We apply the blood to every homeless person. Come on, church, let me hear you say the blood. The blood, the blood, the blood. Hiya, na, 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 na. Every individual on drugs that's listening to this message, we bind the strong man of addiction in the name of Jesus. Come on, warring church, and apply the blood. We bind addiction. We bind cocaine. We bind heroin. We bind marijuana. In the name of Jesus, God sent an angel. Put him on the run. Go in every room, God. Shut up the way of the enemy. Oh, Father, Shanda. It's the blood of Jesus. Oh, yeah, na, 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 Dios. Oh, yeah, na, 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 Dios. Oh, glory. Na, 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 Dios. Oh. We possess our minds tonight, for you've given us the mind of Christ, and we apply the blood in our minds. Come on, church, and apply the blood in your mind right now. Oh, the blood. The blood in the subconscious mind. The blood in the thoughts. The blood in the thought patterns. The blood of Jesus. The blood prevail. We bind you, Satan. We drive you out of the mind. We drive out all highness. In the name of Jesus. We bind insanity. In the name of Jesus. Say to the Lord, rebuke you. The blood yet prevails. Oh, the blood.
Some of y'all don't know what I'm talking about. Go to YouTube. You'll see what I'm talking about. The Lord brought us from a mighty long ways. But she remembered those days, and I appreciate that. But I just want to dedicate this song to all of y'all. When I look back over my life, and I see all the things God's done for me. Been through danger, heartache and trouble, I thank the Lord, He's rescued me. But the Lord, He's made my life. Oh, yes, He did. Now I can say, look at me, y'all. I'm still here. And it's by the grace. Anybody knows by the, anybody knows by the, anybody knows by the, anybody knows by the, anybody knows. It's by the grace of God. How many survivors I got in the house? Then you know what I'm talking about. Oh, when I look back over my life and I see all the things the Lord has brought me through. Anybody ever been through sickness? Trial and suffering. I thank the Lord. He's blessed me still. Oh, I could have lost the faith. And Sister Oliver, after being in the church, I could have slapped somebody in a face. Y'all could have too, huh? Thank God for the Holy Ghost. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Just lift your hand and say, Lord, I thank you for the Holy Ghost. Some of us could have been and should have been incarcerated, but now we can say that we're still here, and it's by the grace. Anybody know it's by the, anybody know it's by the, anybody know it's by the grace of God. And that's why I got to say that I am still here, and it's by the grace of God. Come on, First Jurisdiction, help me out. Oh, I am still, yeah.
It's by the grace.
It's by the grace of God that I am what I am. No. I'm still here, y'all. Nobody knows the story behind my glory. Oh, every time I look back and see what God has done for me, it's by the grace of God. Oh, that He kept me in my right mind and name. Oh, Lord, I'm still here. Anybody grateful that you're still here? When the enemy tried to take you out, oh, before your time. Oh, but I'm still here. Yes, I am. Some folk have died with the same sickness you got right now. But you ought to lift your hand and say that I'm still here, y'all. Yes, I am. Oh, the enemy tried to kill me. Tried to tell me that I never lived to see another day. It's by the grace. Oh, I gotta say, if it had not been for the Lord on my side, yeah. It's by the grace of God that I am what I am, what I am. Oh, yeah. revival. Come on, open your mouth and celebrate your survival. Come on, it's just another day that the Lord has kept you. Kept your mind, kept your will, kept your heart. And even though the enemy came in like a flood, God kept you through it all. And I'm still here to talk about it. I'm still here to be a testament that God is able to keep you from falling. God is able to keep your mind if you can just keep your mind stayed on Him. And I just want you to know that God has, since the last time you saw me, God has kept me through it all. Anybody in here can say on your row, I know God kept me. I don't know.
We're going to leave you with just a line. I can do all things. We don't dare take advantage of this Sunday morning worship without letting you know that I can do all things through Christ. Touch your neighbor, say, you can make it. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. We'll be right back. Somebody say you can make it. Hallelujah. Strengthen me. Hold on. I know I can. Thank you, Jesus.
Embark on a quick four-week journey through the book of Romans. This Palestine epistle encompasses a vast amount of foundational theological truth for the Christian life. The series is a bird's-eye view, 30,000 feet, describing the sinfulness of humanity, the atoning work of Christ, the transforming power of the Spirit, and the new ethic for a Christian life. In this first week of this sermon series, we will examine the text, Romans, the first chapter, 18 through the 32nd verse, Romans, the second chapter, 1st through the 29th verse, and Romans, the third chapter, the 1st through the 20th verse. Now we will look at today's sermon text more in-depthly, sin, fallen, and judgment. All humanity is corrupt by sin and is under God's wrath. We will realize that our own sinfulness, moreover, and definitely that we will realize our need for a Savior. More earnestly, we will open by addressing God because He is the one we are praying to. Let's pray. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we have sinned against You through our own fault in thought and word and in deed, and we have left things undone. For the sake of Your Son, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, forgive us of all our offenses and grant us that we may serve You in the newness of life. To the glory of Your name, amen and amen. Please now follow me to the late 300s AD. A North African young man was troubled by his struggles with sin and the emptiness that various philosophers could not fill. It was in this struggle that he now reads Romans, the 13th chapter, the 13th and 14th verse. And his life was changed forever. The man would go on to be one of the greatest church leaders and Western philosophers in history. What brought about this transformation for St. Augustine? The reading of the book of Romans, according to Walter A. Irwell and Robert Yerloff. Romans, encountering a New Testament, a historical and theological survey, the third edition. Here in this text, Paul begins his Roman discourse, diagnosing the issues with all humanity. All people are cut off from God because of sin and are subject to his judgment and eternal punishment. He furthermore goes to describe humanity as having the ideal that God, but saying instead of worshiping the creator of the universe, people are worshiping the world. Romans, the first chapter, the 21st and 22nd verse. The idolatry of humanity, wealth, their minds, and sexual practices, verses 26 through 28. Today we will find more over about the good news of the gospel. You must first talk about the bad news. Paul wants to stress the dark and the tragic state of humanity is in Romans, the third chapter and the 26th verse. When sin entered the world, Genesis, the third chapter, it was totally and affected every effect of being human. Sin has made us dead to the things of God, infecting our thoughts, our emotions, and our actions. Sin eventually separated us from our relationship with God and makes us enemies with God and subject to his wrath. Moreover, brothers and sisters, it's very understandable that we must understand that sin can separate us from the love of God. However, we eventually learn here in this text that God is a God of a second chance. God is a God that will help us to do what we need to do, but we must seek God in his humanity and who he is. Prevalently, my brothers and sisters, that sin is very prevalent in this world. It make you do some damnable things and it make you say some damnable things, but even in the hot glory, when you call on that name of Jesus, you get power that from on high that you can put sin at bay, but you must call on that Savior, that one that can wrap his arms around you in the midnight hour, let you know that everything is going to be all right, that one that can touch you like nobody else, that one that can whisper the love of his mercy and his grace in your ear and say, my son, my daughter, don't worry, I got your back, and that sin will take you out, but when you call on me, I can be ever now and ever present in a time of need. Moreover, earnestly, my brothers and sisters, where is sin located? It is located in the human heart. James says that evil and sins come from our eternal desire and thought. James 1:14. Sin is not something that is out of our fallen world, but something that is in you and in me. The idea of sin can be confusing in today's culture. Even in the church, we are labeled certain behaviors as sin, murder, idolatry, etc., and the other things merely of our falls or personal struggles, pride, envy, etc. However, one way to describe sin is missing the mark. Sin. Sin is very prevalent. But brothers and sisters, think of a bird's eye view of a target. Your goal is to hit the bird's eye view when you shoot at the target. It doesn't matter if you miss the bird eye by a yard or a millimeter. You still miss the mark. It does not matter if sin is a yard, murder, or a millimeter, pride. You will have to still miss God's bird eye of holiness. God's not rely on you, but he relies on your thoughts and what you do and how that you do it. God does not show favoritism when it comes to sin. Romans, the second chapter and the 11th verse. All sin must be judged. Paul widens the sin net to include not only pagan cultures, but also the righteousness of culture. Paul wants us to understand things like this, that sin, can rough our relationship with God, and that sin is evil. Sin can take us out from God. Sin can make us miss the mark with God because we allow the devil to come in and take full control of our thoughts, our minds, our action, and everything we do. But oh, when you call on the name Jesus, you can get power from on high, power to subdue the devil, power to walk in everything of God, and power to walk in his purpose, and power to walk in things. Sin can take you out of the relationship with God. But brothers and sisters, I want to declare to you and let you understand, the Bible says, whoever call on me, I will keep you in perfect peace. That means that you can be in a peaceful situation, a peaceful mind, when the situation seems like it's not. See, your mind can be terrible, but God can transform you when you call on that great name of Jesus. Even there, equally, we must understand God is right here. He's letting you know that we must understand and learn three things from this sermon today. Firstly, that sin has made us dead to the things of God, influencing our thoughts, emotions, and action. Secondly, sin eventually separates us from the relationship with God and makes us enemies with God and subject to his wrath. Finally, one way to describe sin is missing the mark, Romans 3 and 10. It is my prayer today that after you are hearing this sermon, you will pray to God in any area that sin is taking you out of pocket with God. Can you now pray with me? Please bow your heads. Let's pray. Lord, we need your strength to vend this thing that we are calling sin. We are so thankful for your power that it has made us perfect in our weakness. We cannot boast in our sin, but boast in you who works in the weakness to make us more like you. We know that we have the opportunity to glorify you by fighting against this thing called sin in our lives. Moreover, Father, give us wisdom and the perspectiveness in the moment that we are tempted to sin. Help us in the moment to see our sin and see you in it. Not to be of the sinful nature of matter, but touch our hearts for the longevity of our life. O Lord, who will save us from this body of death, we thank you, O God. Thank you, Lord, for rescuing us and saving us from our sinfulness. It is only in your grace that we are saved, and we are truly thankful. In your name we pray, amen. What if we could become all that God requires us to be? Can you imagine life without sin? God bless you.